For more updates, click on subscribe and click on bell button for latest notifications. Hi friends, welcome to Tech ARK IT YouTube channel. My name is Ravi. In this video session, we are going to see that RHEL 8M repository setups.
Like, share, comment, and subscribe.
So basically in RHEL 6 or 7, the REM repository is a little bit different and the setup is different. Here the M repository setup for the actual RHEL installation media ship with these two components, which is called AppStream repository and BaseOS repository. So we have to configure them in a little different way so that in RHEL 8 it works. Otherwise, so if you set up as a normal like RHEL 7, it won't work. So AppStream is used for installing the applications and BaseOS is used to install the BaseOS required packages on the BaseOS. So that's the purpose of over here. So what I'm going to do is that I'm just going to create a one directory called RPMs and I'm just going to dump the entire content of my DVD repository to this RPMs. Okay, so here if I go to /mnt, so this is my DVD content repository. So in this, the entire content is not required. Example say that the images, ISO, Linux, all this not required. EFI also is not required. Just you have to copy these two directories from here. So one is AppStreams, another one is the BaseOS. So what I'm going to do here is that I'm just going to copy this AppStreams to /RPMs. Okay, so I'm just going to pass this video until this copy done. Okay, maybe first of all I will copy this BaseOS, so it will take a small time to copy this one. Okay, so maybe you do not put V and it takes little time to copy this. So the copy has been completed. Now you can copy the AppStream to /RPMs. So now both the BaseOS and AppStreams are copied. Now let's go to /RPMs and see there are two directories which are copied the data. Now what we have to do is that we have to go to the /etc/m.repos.d and here we have to create the .repo files in order to let it work off this AppStream and BaseOS. So first of all I'm just going to create AppStream.repo, any name you can give, just I want it to be an identical, so that's why I say AppStream repo like this. Anything you can give, maybe I can give like this or let it be AppStream. Okay, so the name you can give anything over here, AppStream repo, something like this you can give. I want in quotation because I have some space here, base URL. So here I'm just going to give the base URL as files :// rpm/appstreams. So this is what my directory name is. And enabled equal to 1, gpg check equal to 0. So if gpg equal to 1, then you have to specify the path name. So I'm just copying this AppStreams as base os dat repo. Now I'm just going to edit this baseOS.repo. So here I just have to change this path of the AppStream to baseOS so that work for us. So here I just have to change the path to baseOS. So now here the name is baseOS repo. That's it. So first of all, I have to verify that whether it is correct or not. The path is so AppStream and baseOS. So now we can cat it the configuration files m.repos.d and baseOS, and you can see that's correct RPMs, and you can just see that AppStream is also correct. So now first of all, clean this all the before repository, all the stuff. Okay, now the DB will be cleaned up. Now type repo list. So it just going to give you the repo list. So AppStream repo and baseOS repo. So both the repos, it's working fine. So in order to register your the all the packages, what you have to do is rpm --import and give the this release, redact release, so that it won't ask you whenever you install that it gives you error that this package is not licensed, something like that. So in order to avoid that, from the media there is a file called redact-release, redact-gpgk-release. You have to import that so that the error will be avoided. That's about it, guys. Setting up your RHEL repository, AppStream and baseOS. So if you want to install any package, you can just install it. So it's working fine. Maybe you can say yes. So the HTTP is going to be installed on this machine. That's about it, guys. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned. Please subscribe to the channel for more upcoming videos and courses. Do not miss the comment section where I have provided this upgrade to RHEL 8 course playlist URL, and you can click on that URL and see all of this upgrade to RHEL 8 course content. Please follow us on social networking sites. If you have any technical related questions, you can ask.